Hello, I am Shantanu Chakravarti and welcome to Samvad's Learning First, knowledge that makes difference. And today, we are going to learn about an event which was centered far from India but was celebrated in India too. I am talking about Taiwan National Day. Let me start with extending my warmth and greetings to all the Chinese as well as Taiwanese citizens a very happy National Day. Taiwan, a small island nation which is not even considered as an independent country by majority of the major powers. It is rather considered as a colony of communist China. But this viewpoint is rapidly changing. All thanks to China's intentional spread of Wuhan virus all over the world, shrinking economies and Chinese aggression with all of its neighbors. The world is angry, and sympathies are moving towards those nations which are fighting against communist China and giving them a bloody nose. Recently, Chinese embassy in India tried to dictate terms to Indian media houses. They specifically targeted Vyond, which is in fact banned in China. Chinese embassy in India want to dictate Indian media houses what to show and what not to show. They want Chinese media houses not to cover Taiwan National Day. But this move backfired. Taiwan National Day was trending at number one position at Twitter India. Indian media houses, both Hindi as well as English news channels, as well as independent journalists, covered the entire event. Now here is a learning for China. Never try to dictate terms to India. When a country of a billion plus people speaks, the world listens. Now what is Taiwan National Day and how it all started? Let's get a look into that. Taiwan National Day is also referred as Double 10th Day, is the national day celebrated in Taiwan on 10th of October. It commemorates the start of Wuchang Uprising on 10th of October 1911, which led to the end of Imperial Qing Dynasty and establishment of Republic of China on 1st of January 1912. Following the conclusions of Chinese Civil War, government of Republic of China lost to communism and retreats to small island Taiwan in December 1949. From then onwards, National Day is celebrated in Taiwan and its administered territories. The official celebrations begins with raising the flag of Republic of China in front of presidential office building along with public singing of national anthem. Speaking of Taiwanese flag, do you know that white sun patch in Taiwan's flag was the flag of Tong Menghui, or translated as Chinese United League, which was led by Sun Yat-sen, which defeated Qing Dynasty and ended the imperial rule in China. In August 1912, Tong Menghui formed the nucleus of Kuomintang, the governing political party of the republic, which was led by Chiang Kai-shek, who was also the first president of Taiwan. Now speaking of the celebrations, it is huge. From military parade to lion dance, drum teams and cultural features coming from Taiwanese aboriginals are integrated into display. Later president of Taiwan addressed the country, followed by fireworks all over the country. But all these celebrations are not very smooth. It has been history that China sends its warships and planes to Taiwan to threaten her. Taiwanese Air Force drove them away. China, which is very sensitive about Taiwan and its One China policy, goes on to threaten Taiwan, but also those nations which will celebrate or support Taiwan in any way. Ever since the outbreak of Wuhan virus, which killed millions all across the globe, governments may be silent due to diplomatic reasons, but citizens are not buzzing away from slamming China. Sooner or later, there will be a government which will dump One China policy and recognize Hong Kong, Taiwan and Tibet as independent countries. I hope that day will come soon. I hope you like this video. Please subscribe to our channel. See you in our next analysis.